wit, everything. Deborah, I too have quit everything. My health insurance company sent me a letter of congratulations, and my life insurance company sent a letter requesting specifics. I told them, yeah, that includes breathing. I quit my car Monday at the intersection of Garfield and Independence Avenue and walked straight to the Quick Trip. I am now a person of interest sought by the police, according to an evening news broadcast I watched just before I quit the TV. I carried it out back where it sits now, connected by a large brown extension cord. It appears stormy with lightning in the backyard. The neighbors have thrown rocks over the fence, but they haven't hit it yet. I quit reading Thursday at the office around noon and haven't read a word since, though it makes me feel lonely. I quit eating Friday while sitting in the local Burger King, where I pushed my meal onto the floor where it lay like a small dead animal and drew pitying comments from the locals. I quit my job on Tuesday after spending all Monday sucking down ices at the Quick Trip. I heard one frantic call from my supervisor before I quit my answering machine. After finally finding my way home through all those dark neighborhoods, my attempts to quit breathing are failing miserably. My lung cycle gases in and out, heedless of my decision. I have sincerely tried to quit light, but the sun continues to rise every morning, and I still see the orange patterns of clouds and curtains move across my eyelids. And at night, I still see the distant flashes of the TV as each screen draws itself suddenly like the birth of a new idea.